Your morning news now. Wisconsin Governor Tony Evers is calling in the National Guard to protect state buildings following violence in Madison. The move was in preparation that more protests would erupt overnight, but so far the city has been mostly peaceful. On Tuesday, protesters toppled two statues, one of which represented an abolitionist who fought to end slavery. Demonstrators also attacked a state senator who was attempting to take a photo. The violence broke out over the arrest of a black man on Tuesday who shouted at restaurant customers through a megaphone while carrying a baseball bat.
The only thing that's being heard and worried about right now is these statues, you know, not about how black people is getting took away from their family.
Controversial statues continue to come down throughout the country, but some black activists say the efforts do very little for the true cause. They say that tearing down the monuments is taking away from the movement for black justice nationwide. President Trump is expected to sign an executive order protecting historical monuments by the end of the week. A Defense Department official says 400 National Guard members have been activated in Washington, D.C. in part to help protect monuments. However, none have been dispatched to those locations.
Well, the concern this morning, some fairly thick fog is seen through our CityCam 8 network this morning. Visibility down to a quarter mile or less in Winona, La Crosse, Sparta, Black River Falls, Prairie du Chien, and Boscobel. So slower speeds this morning. Make sure you have your headlights on so that others can see you. Once this fog mixes out by about 8 o'clock or so, a sunny to partly cloudy sky today.
After months of speculation on whether Milwaukee will hold its Democratic National Convention, finally we have the answer. The DNC will go on, but it will be held almost entirely virtual. Party officials confirm Joe Biden will accept the presidential nomination in person. The question is whether there will be a significant in-person audience there to see it. Yesterday, the U.S. reported its largest single-day increase in coronavirus cases since the outbreak began. Three states that now have the virus under control, New York, New Jersey, and Connecticut, have implemented a travel advisory requiring visitors in nine states to self-quarantine for 14 days. Nevada will start requiring everyone to wear masks, including at casinos, and a highly disputed mask requirement goes into effect this morning in Palm Beach County, Florida, after residents were upset during a county meeting. New this morning, Wisconsin residents can now apply for 13 more weeks of unemployment benefits. Additional funding will be used from the federal coronavirus relief bill. The State Department of Workforce Development says Wisconsin residents who have exhausted their 26 weeks of state unemployment benefits can now apply for pandemic emergency unemployment compensation. The application deadline for the Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation's We're All In grants is being extended. Applications can be filed through tomorrow. More than 26,000 businesses in the state had filed for the $2,500 grants by the original deadline on Tuesday. Application information is available on the WEDC website. The first round of payments will be released next month.
They're usually brought to tears by all the help that we've given them.
A summer program teaching kids how to connect with communities around the country is staying local this year. Prince of Peace Work Camp takes kids on mission trips to different states, but this summer's trip was canceled. So organizers are taking a different approach. Kids are volunteering in La Crescent, making repairs to four homes and making Veterans Park handicap accessible. Another youth mission trip is sticking to its roots this year. Jaywalkers, a program for high school teens ran by Holy Family Parish in Prairie du Chien, had their mission trip canceled because of the pandemic. So they're staying in the community doing maintenance on a Catholic school, improving a local park, helping the elderly, and more throughout the week. Road work in Crawford County will continue to impact drivers in the coming month. Work on U.S. Highway 18 bridges over the Mississippi River will continue to the fall. The bridge is open with lane restrictions, and Wisconsin Highway 35 is closed to through traffic between Genoa and Stoddard. There are signs posted for a detour. Wisconsin Highway 82 between Wisconsin and Lansing, Iowa is still closed and will remain closed until July 2nd.
Well, temperatures this morning starting out in the 50s for most, 48 though in Sparta with that thick fog scattered about. That'll mix out, then we'll see a sunny to partly cloudy sky, warmer and dry today with highs in the low to mid 80s, right around 85 in La Crosse. Now, storms return tomorrow. In fact, a level 1 to 2 severe risk, level 1 for La Crosse and north and west, level 2 risk for our southern and eastern communities. Local timing from about noon to 6 p.m. Strong winds, I think, the primary threat. Some locally heavy downpours as these storms race through as well, maybe some hail. So tomorrow an alert day just to stay extra weather aware, and we will keep you updated with the latest heading into tomorrow morning.
All right, thanks a lot, Bill, and thank you so much for your time this morning. CBS This Morning follows us here. For Bill Grawl, I'm Jordan Fremstead. Jennifer Livingston returns tomorrow. Have a great day.